In today's video, I'll hopefully be showing you how you can optimize Kerbal Space Program 2 for the best graphics and frame rate. I've tested each of the graphics options to give you what I think is right now the best settings to create the perfect balance between graphics and performance. The specs of the PC I'm using is a Ryzen 5 5600X with an RTX 3070 and 32GB of RAM at 3200MHz. Of course, every individual system and scenario is different, so if you have any experience from the game and how to optimize it, then post it in the comments and I will try and keep a pinned comment that compiles all the best advice. Let's start off by showing you the raw data from my tests. Feel free to pause the video here to get a better look. Basically, we have each test on the side and the resultant minimum, average, and maximum frame rate. This test was done with the exact same scenario, a simple launch to 10,000 meters, so any noticeable differences in frames should indicate transferable tips to boost FPS. Now let's head into the game and I'll show you what worked best for me in the tests. We'll start with the quality preset if you want a quick way to optimize the game. There wasn't really any difference between any of the three options and FPS stayed relatively the same in each test. If you really want to maximize frames, then choose medium, but this only gained 1 frame per second on average, so the trade-off is probably not worth it, and you may as well leave it on high. However, we can look through some of the individual quality options, as there are some that you may want to set manually. There was very little difference with anti-aliasing, with only 1 frame per second average being lost when going from off to 4x to 8x. So you may as well want to leave this on 8x unless you really want to gain the extra frame or two. Anisotropic filtering made zero difference to the frames in the tests, so again you may as well leave this turned on. Changing the resolution as expected did have a considerable effect. All other tests are done at 4K, which is why the frame rate was between 18 and 30, but you can get a big boost with average frame rate jumping from 24 to 37 when going from 4K down to 1440p, and then up to 41 with 1080p. All this means is you can set it to which you prefer, as obviously reducing the resolution drastically affects the visuals, but in my tests, 1440p seemed to offer the best experience on a 4K monitor. The frame rate was boosted nicely without losing all of the quality. Now let's look at some more of the individual graphics options to fine-tune our setup. Environment prop didn't start to impact frame rate until it was set to high, so you can probably turn it on and set both the options to medium for the best combination without it impacting frames. Changing the water quality made virtually no difference. Average frame rate was the same on each of the options, so you may as well set it to high. The same can be said for both shadow quality and shadow details, so set these to high too. Although I would be interested to see if this is the same on other spec PCs. The first big difference was when I reduced the cloud quality. Setting this to low increased FPS by about 10% in the tests compared to high. So if you can put up with the lower quality, setting this to low should give you a healthy boost in FPS. Even if it's a few frames, it should still make a difference. Out of curiosity, I also experimented with VSync on and off, and there was no difference. I also tried turning on no crash damage and unbreakable joints, but this also provided no increase in FPS. Those are the settings. There are a few other things to mention. The performance of the game at the moment heavily depends on what you're looking at, as the game runs perfectly smooth for me in orbit at a constant 60fps with VSync on. If I look at the ground at Kerbin, this drops instantly to around the 25fps mark, so bear this in mind, and this could improve your experience. I didn't run any FPS tests with the max debris setting lowered. I think this is obvious that turning this all the way down will improve FPS in the event of a RUD. Once again, I think it would be beneficial if you can let me know of your experience and what works best for you, so I can keep the pinned comment updated with the optimal settings. I have separate videos that cover many ways to boost FPS in Windows 10 or 11. You can view those with the links on screen now. Those cover methods that will help in every game and ensure that your PC itself is optimized for gaming. Thanks so much for watching. If you found the video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. I'll see you in another video.